Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, let's talk about Euler angles. Let's get started. Euler angles are a way to represent the orientation of an object in space. It's a very complex and advanced topic, and my goal here is not to give you an advanced maths or robotics class. I might do that in the future, but here I just wanted you to understand enough about the topic and the concept to be able to take full advantage of the feature RoboDK provides. So let's start by opening our file. So as usual, if you go down in the description of this video, you will find the link to download the files. At the same time, you can click subscribe and like the video. That would be awesome. Here you have 0.7D Euler angles. So I'm just gonna bring that one here. And we just start with a simple KUKA robot. As usual, if you double click on the robot, you can open the robot panel. We already talked about those colorful boxes. So here, the first three ones will always represent the same thing. So X, Y, and Z. So the position of the tool. In this case, we only don't have any tool attached to the robot flange. So therefore, we're using the robot flange as a reference. And we don't have any reference frame. So we're using the robot base as our reference. Afterwards, here we have three other boxes, so one cyan, one magenta, and one yellow. And according to that drop-down menu here, they represent Z, Y prime, X prime prime. So the goal here for this video is to understand what this means. And so what this means, if you click on the drop-down menu, you will see that you have a bunch of other options, and we will explore what those options represent or are in the next video. So I'm gonna stick here to ABB Kukanachi. Those are relatively well-known and used robot brands. So by default, when I'm at my home position with the KUKA robot, my orientation here are 0, 90, 0. To make the explanation a bit easier, I'm gonna start with 0 everywhere. So this way, you'll be able to kind of follow along the different steps to reach that 0, 90, 0 or any other values for that matter. So if you look right now between the base reference frame here and the tool reference frame or flange reference frame in this case, there is only a translation. So a translation of 525, 0, 890. There is no rotation. So the Z axis is aligned with the tool Z axis. The y-axis is aligned with the y-axis, the x-axis is aligned with the y-axis. If I was to come here and use my scroll wheel to modify here the value, you would see that I'm rotating around the z-axis. You might be tempted to think that I'm rotating around the z-axis of the tool, but in fact, I'm rotating around the z-axis of the base here, because everything is with respect to the base. Here, if I rotate around the y-axis, I would be rotating around the y-axis again of the base, like that. And if I bring that back to 0, I would be rotating around the x-axis, so the x-axis of the base again. The thing is, this is the case because everything is at 0 and I'm only modifying or playing with one of the values. There's a little thing that you need to notice here. There are some primes here or apostrophe here after the y and x values. So we have z, we call that prime. So z, y prime, and x prime prime. Those means that we are rotating around the original z axis of the base. Then after that z rotation is applied, we'll be rotating around the newly created y-axis. And then once this rotation is applied, we'll be rotating around the newly created x-axis. So if I give you an example, if I rotate around, let's say I'm rotating around the other direction. Let's say if I rotate around the z-axis 90 degrees or minus 90 degrees. So now I have this as a new reference. If I decide to rotate around the y-axis or apply rotation around the y-axis, I won't be rotating around this y-axis here. I'll be rotating around the newly created y-axis. So if I go like that, It's the same as if I was rotating around the x-axis I had before. This only happens because I rotated like 90 degrees, so the newly created y-axis aligned with the old or original x-axis. So if I go 60 degrees like that, and then if I rotate around the x-axis, it's not this red x-axis, it's this newly created x-axis. So if I rotate like that. So I like this this method because it's kind of intuitive where you are rotating. So you're rotating around the z-axis, then the newly created y-axis, then the newly created x-axis. If I bring that back to home, the reason why this is 0, 90, 0, it's because here we have no rotation around the z-axis, then we rotate 90 degrees around the y-axis, so 90 degrees will bring us, so if I go back to 0, 90 degrees will bring us in this direction, and then we're fine with that. If I want to create a target, let's say, if I'm going to bring that down here, if I want to create a target at, in this case, 45, I have multiple ways of creating a target at a 45 degree angle in this direction. I can go for minus 180, 45, 180, because if I take this one here, I'm going to bring that all back to zero, so that I can kind of go one step at a time. Oh, I'm sorry. Zero. If I go minus 180, this is what was used. Oops, I wanted to have minus. Minus 180 with respect to the z-axis. Perfect, like that. If I go 45 with respect to the newly created y-axis, then if I rotate 180 degrees with respect to the newly created x-axis, it brings me to that position. But here, that's one way to represent it. But I have another way to represent the exact same rotation. If I bring everything back to zero, like that, I can decide to simply rotate around the y-axis. Sorry, home, zero, I'm kind of near the end of the reach. So if I simply rotate around the y-axis 135 degrees, I have the exact same position as I had with the minus 180, 45, and 180. So just keep in mind that multiple values of Euler angle can give you the exact same rotation. So now I can create, let's say, a target here in this orientation here, and press F3 to take a look at it. And here in this case, it decided that minus 180, 45, and 180 was the best option to showcase that. But 0, 135, 0 would have done the exact, would have gave you the exact same value. So that's pretty much everything for this video. I don't want it to be too long and too deep. So it's, I know it's a bit complicated, so I would recommend you to play with that a bit. In the next video, we'll see different Euler angle representation depending on which robot brand you're using and some traps to avoid. So I hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys.